version of the Wico i6 is slightly different compared to the normal one, which means like the back cover is not the same, the camera is different also, and the screen is different. So this is these three things that we will go through in this review. Besides that, we will still look at the hardware and everything. So let's open the box first. So inside we have a smartphone, of course, we'll get back to it later. So also we have just one quick usual manual guide, all in English, which is kind of the same like what you can find actually for the real iPhone, but this is not that interesting. So you have some earphones, so copy of original ones. We have USB charger, so this is a EU plug, but when you check out on our website you can also have actually the UK or the US plug. You just have to choose the right one when you check out. And last but not least, we have a USB cable, so it's a lightning cable, so you see the end isn't the same like the normal Android, so this is really like iPhone. And basically that's it. So now let's have a look at the smartphone itself. So this is the Wico i6 HD. So as I said before, this smartphone has the same exact dimensions than the original one. So I repeat, so this is 138 by 67 by 7 millimeters thickness. So regarding the design, you see that this is actually exactly the same. So it's like having an iPhone in your hands. For the weight, we have here 129 grams. The first Wico i6 or Thunderbird of Vphone, depending on how you call it, you know, a lot of people have changed the names. This is what is going on in China. But this one actually has a metal aluminum back cover, though the previous one only had like a plastic back cover. So this one is actually more heavy and holds better in hands. And what I want to say is about the screen as well, so we can see what's going on here on the edges. So the screen is completely like curved and running on the edges, and just is very smooth on the edges basically. So it's slightly different than the iPhone 6, because here we still have this little plastic edge. And the original one actually really like is completely curved and going inside the back cover. So this is the only difference maybe you could find between the iPhone 6 and this copy. Otherwise it looks exactly the same. So on the bottom we have the speaker, the lightning cable here, and the 3.5 mm jack and two screws on the microphone. On the side we have exactly the same too, so the volume buttons, and here this is actually a switch to activate the the silence mode or the normal mode for the ringtones. On the top we have nothing. On the other side we have here for the SIM card to open it, so this is a one nano SIM card only for the smartphone, and the power button here. Also on the back here we have a 13 megapixels camera with microphone and flash. And on the front, we have here a 5 megapixels camera and the proximity light sensor. On the bottom here, we have the home button, which looks exactly like the original one, to be honest. And otherwise, we still have a 4.7 inch screen. So this one is different from the previous ones. The previous one had a resolution of 960 by 540. This one is actually still an IPS screen, but HD with a resolution of 1280 by 720. So we'll see the difference is quite cool to watch movies on it. Here again, you cannot take off the back cover, so it's non-removable. So you cannot insert any SD card, so you have to deal with the storage inside. However, this smartphone on our website is available in three colors. So we have black, silver and gold. So this is actually the black one. So it's more like, you know, dark color. Then we have like three different kind of storage too. So we have 8 GB, 16 GB, and 32 GB. So you can choose when you check out the color and the storage, because after that you will not be able to change actually the storage. So this is it. Choose the right storage and choose the right color, and then check out. So otherwise, regarding the battery, we have here a 2000 mAh battery. So some people, my thing is a bit too just for them. So it will last just a day with an average use, so you don't have to overuse this smartphone for sure. But for the normal people, basically, it will last a day for sure. So now what I propose to you is just to get started and just to turn on the smartphone to see what's going on. So if we just press the power button, we have the logo Apple which is appearing. So here we go. So we can just slide. So that's it. So we have here, okay, most of the people, if they look at it, they will think, wow, this is iOS, it's so cool. In fact, okay, this is Android 4.2 and we have iOS 8 theme on it. So it's still based on Android. How would you detect that right away? For example, if we launch the Apple Store here, we see this is actually the Play Store, so this is a good indication, okay? So basically it's Android but with iOS 8 theme. So we still have here the assistive touch, so which is improved compared to the last version we had for the Wico. So if we click on it here, we see that is actually quite a lot. So we have the notification center, Siri, which is actually the Google speaking, home, control center, the device and menu. So if we go to notification center, basically the same, like actually just going down, you know, with your finger. So you have access here to today for the calendar and all the scheduled events you have or have planned. Notifications. So here you will see all the messages and everything regarding to what happened in your smartphone. Also, if you start from the bottom, you have here these toggles appearing. So we have here the airplane mode, the Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, night modes, and auto rotation. The brightness set up to the maximum here, as you see. Otherwise, you have a direct access actually to your music player, AirDrop, the flashlight, calculator, camera, and you have quite a lot of quick access to a lot of different things. So it really looks like an iPhone, to be honest. So regarding the assistive touch, I didn't finish yet. So this was actually for the notification center. So it's like the same, like dropping your and swiping your finger to the bottom. For the device here, you can choose right away for auto rotation, lock screen, Wi-Fi, silent, Bluetooth, GPS. You can just come back then to the menu, just come back here basically. So if we click on it here, if you go to the control center, it's just same like going up with your finger. Basically this is it for the assistive touch. So otherwise, what is provided by default in this smartphone when you get it? So you have the messaging, calendar, gallery, camera, weather, clock, maps, video player, notes, reminder, game center, newsstand, so the Play Store, so you can download all your favorite applications directly with your Google account. We have the compass, we can just quickly, so we see that this is working. Alright, so then we have the health center, kind of. So just you choose basically, you know, I mean, how much weight you are, whatsoever, you know, the height, and then when you're born, and then you just like decide, you know, like about some other settings and just press next, and then you can see actually what is your goal. So you can actually take the smartphone with you and plan during the day how much effort you have to make and how much or how many calories you have to burn or whatsoever just to keep you fit. So it's kind of the same, like you can set up some fitness goals. So it's a bit similar to the S Health from Samsung, but it's a bit more simple basically. So otherwise we have access to the settings too. So before going to the settings, we can just finish here. So on extra, we have the contacts, calculators, and downloads, podcasts, social. So you can have like all the different applications like WeChat, WhatsApp, Line, Viber, whatever, FaceTime, iTunes Store. Yeah. Here, instead of the iTunes Store, it's like 7 Digital. So you can still buy some songs and listen to some other stuff. You can create an account. So you can download other applications if you want, so iBooks for the books, of course, voice memos, and all the rest is just some applications we have installed for this review. By the way, we will check that later for the camera, but we advise you to install like a third-party application for the camera to have access to more settings for the ISO and all different things like that. So here we advise, for example, Camera 360, which is quite cool, and you can even use the AB Shooter 3 for Bluetooth, for example, if you want to take a picture at Bluetooth range. So this is it. So otherwise, now let's have a look at the settings. So here we can start. So we have the airplane mode. We can activate the Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, cell phone network, and the carrier if you have the SIM card inserted. Notifications. So you can see what was missed for the calls and SMS. Control center. So here they say push up from the bottom of the screen, display send control center, so you can have an access on the lock screen or access within the applications. Then do not disturb mode, in general, if we go inside, so we can have access to about the phone, so it will tell you what is going on. So here we have actually the 16 gigabytes version, but I repeat, we have the 8, 16 and 32 gigabytes, not the 64, the 64 gigabytes is not available. I mean, at least not yet, maybe in the future. Software update, you see, so this is iOS 8, but this is the theme, this is not the real one. So Siri is actually for Google. So we can activate if you want, but this is... So you have Spotlight search, you can use Spotlight, which is like even better than 7 Digital to find some music and to listen to some music on the go. Accessibility, usage, auto lock, restriction, date and time, keyboard, international. This is where you find the languages. So here's the list. So you have a lot of things. You might probably find yours inside. So you see, to come back, for example, I can just quickly tap on the assistive touch, and here I go back. Easy, very easy. So the VPN wireless update, the iTunes Wi-Fi synchronization doesn't work, of course, because there is no iTunes on it. Display and brightness, so here we see this is set up to the maximum wallpaper, so you can change, you can choose a new one if you want. For the sounds, it's the same, like basically you can just change your ringtones and customize all of that. The touch code, so here it looks exactly like the original one. iPhone unlock, iTunes and App Store, add a fingerprint. Okay, this is, to be honest, fake. So you can try to use it and you will see, you will pretend that you're recognizing your finger on it, but it's just a gadget, it doesn't work, it's not safe. So please bear that in mind. If you want to use it, it's maybe good to push away some people. Maybe they will think that they need really the finger, but this doesn't work, so this is not safe. Privacy. So here, this is where you find the location services for the GPS, personal hotspots, device administrators, and all kind of certificates. iCloud, mail, contacts, calendar. This is just to customize your different applications right away. You have developer options. So for the people who are more confident or more advanced, you know, with basically some settings. So you don't have access to a lot, but still quite a little. And now let's talk a bit about the specifications. This is actually what we want to check out. So we did the Antutu benchmark test for you already. So for the people who don't know what is a benchmark, is actually an application at least for Android, which allows you to test the performances of your device and to get a score out of it. So here we get 17,302, which is an average score nowadays for a smartphone, compared to all the new models which came out in the past few months. But still, here we see that we have actually the i6 Vphone, but he has different names depending on where is it from exactly. Android 4.3, we have the CPU, which is MT6582, so quad-core processor clocked at 1.3 GHz. We have the Mali 400 MP for the graphic processor, resolution HD of 1280x720. Here they say this is a 16 megapixels camera, this is fake, it's only a 13 megapixels. No root access, we'll check that later. We have 1 GB of RAM and 16 GB of storage on this one, but remember that you can have 8/16 of 32. Then I was saying that this is a quad-core processor clocked at 1.3 GHz, graphic processor of Mali 400 MP, 320 dpi for the density, multi-touch, we'll try it later on. On the front, we have a 5 megapixels camera, Android 4.3, no NFC on it. Wi-Fi, and for the sensors we have quite a bunch: the direction, acceleration, light, e-compass, and proximity sensor. So basically this is it for the specifications. Now we can have a look actually at the multi-touch. We were just talking about that. So if we put all fingers on it, we see that this is only a 2-touch capacitive screen. So it's not a lot, but at least you can still use 2 fingers to zoom or unzoom, basically. So it's the minimum. Otherwise, let's have a look at the root checker. So here you can really see that your device doesn't have root access. So basically, if you want to change the Android version on it, you will first have to root the smartphone. So this is advised when you want to actually change the Android version. But in any case, just please bear in mind that this device is not rooted. So now what we can try is actually the GPS. So you see that we are here inside the house, so it's very slow, and it cannot really fix yet anything. But we have been trying it outside, it was working quite well. It's just a bit slow. But inside of the house is just too weak and it will not detect it. Now we can actually have a look at the camera. So I will show you both applications. So the one provided by the iOS theme. So this is what you get. So here you don't have many settings, as you can see. So here I can just activate or deactivate or put in auto for the flash. Then the HDR, which is on or off, and then you can just change the front camera, switch from the front to the back camera. And the bottom here, you have actually the videos, camera, or panorama. So it's quite basics, and here you have to share if you want. But it's not many things, and it's not very convenient for most of the people. So this is why I would advise actually to take pictures with camera 360, for example, because here you can actually check everything. So you can change the different photo settings, so the size, the quality, even for the camera, you can change a lot of different things for the ISO and composition, and a lot of different other settings, basically. So we can take, if you want, right away here, just like a quick picture. So here we go. So if we see what's going on, we can see that actually the details are pretty good when you zoom on it. So it's obviously not the same quality, 13 megapixels, than for example the OnePlus or the Huawei Honor 6 or even the P7, but it's still very, a good camera for such a price, basically. So we see that the details are not that bad, not at all when you zoom on it. So we took some other pictures when we were a bit out for some flowers, if you want to check. So here we see that actually the colors are very nice and the details are quite good. So we have here the same, so we see that it's quite far away anyway, so it's quite good. So basically that's it for the camera. So you see that this is not too bad, to be honest, for a clone. So now we can just have a look at a video in order to see what's going on when we play a movie on it, and for the sound and the screen basically. So you see that auto rotation is working perfectly. The sound turned up to maximum. Regarding the viewing angle, looks quite good. So watching movies on it will be quite cool because of this HD screen, resolution of 1280x720, and the colors are actually very, very great and natural. Regarding the sound, this is not the most powerful sound we have seen on the market, but it's still doing a great job. And it will be large enough to watch a movie for sure. So we can just come back. So you can see that watching movies is actually quite good with this HD. Let's have a look at the graphic performances. So for that we can just launch Real Racing 3. Here we go. So you can easily see that there is not much trouble to play it. It's quite smooth. So basically that's it. As you just saw, no problem to play some of the latest games. I thought we only have the Mali 400MP, so it will be able to play some of the latest games. So basically that's it for the test of the Thunderbird Wico i6 HD, so also called the Vphone i6, or even some people were calling it the Goophone i6, but it's a different model as well. So to make a quick summary, here a copy 1-to-1 of the iPhone i6. So the same dimensions and the same weight exactly. So the back cover is in metal aluminum, so which is very nice, and with the logo on it, the real logo, so Apple logo. And the bottom here is the same with the same inscriptions. So we have 13 megapixels on the back with flash, and on the front we have 5 megapixels. Otherwise, the good point compared to the normal Wico i6 we were selling previously is that we do have here the curved edges on the screen, and the screen is actually an HD one with a resolution of 1280x720. For the storage, we actually have three possibilities. So we have 8 GB, 16 GB, or 32 GB. So you can choose the one you want when you check out on our website. So you have 1 GB of RAM inside. The processor is a quad-core processor clocked at 1.3 GHz, so the MediaTek 6582. The screen is a 4.7 inches, so like the original one. We have three colors available, so the black, silver, and gold. Otherwise, regarding the OS inside, so this is Android 4.2, 4.3, but with iOS 8 theme. So it looks like exactly like an iPhone. And last but not least, the battery is actually a 2000mAh battery. So this is what you get at electrofame.com. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below this video and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Otherwise, the last point I would like to talk about is on it's about the shipping. So as you saw here, we have the logo and it's exactly a replica of the iPhone 6. So basically, we propose two different kind of shippings on our website, so DHL and the free shipping. So we just want to tell you that if you take DHL, we will not be held responsible if the customs stop your package at the border. However, if you take the free shipping, there is 99% chance that you will have never any problem with that. So please bear that in mind when you check out on our website. So if you want to get yourself a perfect copy of the iPhone 6, which fits all the official accessories on it, please feel free to visit our website at www.electrofame.com. And otherwise, until then, I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to thumb up if you like the video, and see you later for the next one. Bye bye.